But enough with that peripheral BS, because today's guest is perhaps the most underrated YouTuber of all time. His production quality is beyond anything I've ever seen. Every video has the production quality and visual effects of like a multi-million dollar Hollywood production. It's insane. He's been doing it for 10 years. He's one of my favorite channels, and he's criminally underwatched. You may know him as Captain Disillusion. He's a superhero whose special power is skepticism. He debunks conspiracy theories and fake special effects in a wonderful and comedic way that I have not seen anywhere.
The undisputed heavyweight champion of debunking fake videos using special effects, Captain Disillusion.
I looked up to Captain Disillusion ever since I first saw one of his videos. His skills, talent, production value, not to mention charisma, are off the charts. One day, I found a viral hoax he hadn't touched yet, so I decided to make a video about it and send it to him. I had no way of knowing what would come next. The next month, he puts out his new video, and he didn't just take my suggestion.
Apparently, there is one more viral video left to debunk, and it comes as a special request from an ambitious little boy named Jackson Roberts, who's made a grassroots hoax-busting effort of his own.
He also complimented me directly.
You're a film student with 29 subscribers, Jackson, and I can honestly say that the quality of work on your YouTube channel is better than the quality of work in this whole campaign. So yeah, I don't understand advertising nowadays either.
This was huge. Suddenly, people started watching my films on YouTube. People I looked up to were commenting about me. This was the best thing that had ever happened to me on the internet. The whole experience taught me that my idols were within my reach. If I tried hard enough, I could actually communicate with anyone I wanted to. Up until this point, though, my correspondence with Captain D had only been through YouTube videos and a couple Twitter DMs. I wanted to actually talk to him, face to face. So, I asked him if we could do an interview on Skype. I spent hours preparing for the interview. Writing and rewriting the questions, getting my setup working, even cleaning and lighting my room. And then... So what got you into filmmaking in the first place?
I don't know. I always was fascinated by movies and by animation. And I just kind of knew that I wanted to do something in that arena since I was little. I wasn't sure what, but I always tried to like draw and do little... I never had access to anything when I was young that could actually allow me to do animation, but I tried to like do like little flip books and draw and, you know, pretend to be an animator. But and then when I had access to video cameras and things later in life, I made little short films, and I was always drawn to it. And I went to film school because of it.
So what would you do with an unlimited budget and unlimited time?
I'm always accused, like people I work with or family and stuff, they always think I go overboard with everything. So I think if anything, I need to tone things down. But I suppose if my operation was like a team, like an actual studio making a thing, I would just be more elaborate and creative. It's tough to do that when you're just doing it on your own. But I don't know. I'm not sure how I would change things. I'm always unhappy with the result. I'm one of those people where when I make something, I'll never finish something because I'll keep tweaking it till somebody stops me, and only the deadline that I set for myself always stops me. Otherwise, I'd just keep working on this on one shot and never be done. I don't know if that answers your question.
I realized I wasn't interviewing Captain Disillusion. I was talking to Alan, the guy who made Captain Disillusion. Until now, I had been naively, unfairly building up Captain Disillusion in my head, never thinking about the fact that he doesn't really exist. He was a hoax. I debunked a viral hoax that I created in my own head. But that's okay. It doesn't make me appreciate him any less. In fact, I appreciate him more. The intimacy of YouTube as a platform has given him and his character a legitimacy that you can't get anywhere else. Amongst everyone else on YouTube being a version of themselves, he is a silver-skinned VFX wizard from outer space. And we all just roll with it. As we should.